Hello, and welcome to the 2021 Mad Scientist Award Celebration. I'm Jennifer Davis, Program Planner for Middle and High School Science at the School District of Palm Beach County, and proud director of the Palm Beach Regional Science and Engineering Fair. Thank you for joining us this evening. Tonight, we will celebrate and recognize the 57 Mad Scientists who will represent Palm Beach and Martin counties at the Florida State Science and Engineering Fair. What are Mad Scientists? Well, let me tell you, they are amazing young people. Way back at the crazy beginning of this school year, despite a global pandemic, over 450 students in Palm Beach and Martin counties began researching and planning their original science and engineering projects. Many of them completed their projects at home with limited materials and equipment, but they were supported by their families, teachers, and volunteer mentors from our amazing STEM community. They have competed at their school fairs and at their regional fairs. And now these 57 students have earned a nomination to present their work at the state competition in a few weeks. This year marks the 10-year anniversary of our partnership with the Stiles Nicholson Foundation to celebrate the accomplishments of these young scientists. We are so grateful for the generous support and encouragement from Mr. David Nicholson as we have worked to create a network of Mad Scientist alumni, many of whom I hope are watching tonight. We are also incredibly lucky to have the South Florida Science Center and Aquarium as a sponsor for the third year in a row. In addition, there are dozens of local organizations and individuals who support the fair as mentors, judges, and category award sponsors. In short, it takes a village to do this, and we have an amazing network of support. For the past hour, our 57 students have been getting to know each other in a virtual meeting space where they shared their projects and then competed in groups in a virtual escape room featuring these amazing exhibits here at the Science Center. Now, we will hear from the president of the South Florida Science Center, listen to an inspiring keynote address from Dr. Guy Harvey and his daughter Jessica, and also hear from Mr. David Nicholson of the Stiles Nicholson Foundation. Then, we will recognize all of our Mad Scientists, so be sure to cheer for them virtually in the chat box on the right. We will also recognize four teachers for their dedication to supporting students in science research. I would be remiss if I did not extend special thanks to all of the teachers who have worked so hard this year to mentor every student in their classrooms. I hope you enjoy the evening's activities, and thank you for joining us to celebrate our Mad Scientists. Without further ado, please welcome the President and CEO of the South Florida Science Center, Kate Aritza.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Mad Scientist Awards Ceremony. My name is Kate Aritza, and I'm the President and CEO of the South Florida Science Center and Aquarium. And on behalf of the staff and the board, we're so happy to be here with you tonight. We are excited to be recognizing the best and the brightest that Palm Beach and Martin County have to offer. Personally, I get goosebumps when I look at the caliber of the displays I see here tonight. At the Science Center, our mission is to open every mind to science. These youth that are here tonight are doing just that. Congratulations to all of them. Tonight is very special. Tonight is the 10th anniversary of the Mad Scientist Awards. Woo, woo! The South Florida Science Center, together with the School District of Palm Beach County, the School District of Martin County, and the Stiles Nicholson Foundation, are proud to recognize the top students and their dedicated teachers from the Palm Beach and Martin Regional Science and Engineering Fairs. Before I get to our presenting sponsor, I'd love to thank some individuals who worked tirelessly to see this event through. Thank you to Jennifer Davis and Valerie Gaynor for their never-ending devotion to our students. Thank you to the School District of Palm Beach County and the School District of Martin County for their commitment to STEM education and to the South Florida Science Center staff. And a huge thank you to the parents and teachers for their unwavering support and dedication to the STEM masterminds that will make our world a better place. And now I'd like to introduce the presenting sponsor, the Stiles Nicholson Foundation, chaired by Dr. David Nicholson. The Stiles Nicholson Foundation's mission is to improve and enhance education to help students succeed in the real world, especially through STEM initiatives. Dr. Nicholson, his wife Lynn, and his daughter Leanne work tirelessly to ensure our students have the right tools to succeed in the real world. We are so grateful for everything they have done, not only in our community, but for our country. I now turn it over to Dr. David Nicholson.
Good evening, and welcome to the 10th anniversary of the Mad Scientist Awards reception. I am David Nicholson, founder and chairman of the Stiles Nicholson Foundation, and the originator of this and sponsor of the Mad Scientist Awards. First of all, let me take this opportunity to thank the South Florida Science Center, Kate and Carla, and the Palm Beach School District, especially Jennifer Davis, and the students, parents, and STEM teachers who made this wonderful event all possible. Given the scientists in the audience, I would like to start my presentation by giving you some quantitative thoughts, some numbers, if you will. First of all, let me say, if you can see this, we have 10, 450, 100,000, 93, 7, and 86,000. What do those numbers mean? Well, interestingly enough, the 10 refers to the number of years we've been doing the Mad Scientist Awards, and the 450 refers to the number of students that are actually been award winners, mad scientists, and joined this very, very special club. The 100,000 happens to be the number of dollars that has been awarded to these students over this 10-year period. Now, 93, if you think about 93, 93% of the STEM jobs have earned and do earn significantly more than the average job in the United States. Seven, what's seven mean? Seven out of the 10 largest STEM jobs involve computers and math. Very important. 86,000 refers to and just confirms the idea that STEM graduates are very well paid, but 86,000 refers to the median salary of those graduates whose major is computers and math. It is just a wonderful evening tonight, and it is great to virtually be with you all. You're 45 winners. You effectively, if you think about it, are all-stars. You're all-stars because you beat 190,000 other students in Palm Beach County for this honor. Mathematically, if you want to think about it, 45 versus 190,000, you beat 99.97% of all the other students in Palm Beach County to be here tonight. You and your families and STEM advisors can be justly proud. Importantly, the celebration tonight is not necessarily just about your project. It is about your ability to follow the scientific method and actually solve problems. On a personal note, I am actually an electrical engineer who ended up getting into computer systems upon graduation and optimizing cement plants for IBM and forecasting the stock market later on. Go figure. The bottom line is problem solving is helped immensely by going through this scientific method and analyzing the problem objectively. Today, interestingly enough, you have very exciting problems to solve. You have the environment. You've got energy. You have the space program and Mars. You have viruses. You have artificial intelligence. You've got robotics. You've got diseases that still need to be resolved. Alzheimer's, cancer. You have self-driving cars. Just as a perspective, you might be interested in learning that when I graduated in 1962, you compare computers from then and today, And computers are 1,000 times faster. They are 1,000 times cheaper. And so they are 1,000,000 times more cost effective and still improving. Exciting times to be sure, where STEM careers offer you 3 important features. Fun. You're in a position to have fun and enjoy the challenges of STEM. And I use this as an example. Anyway, you get the idea, and it's fun. It could be challenging. I think about all the programming that went into getting that timing and the synchronization, etc. It's not only fun, but it can be very rewarding. As I mentioned, the salaries in STEM careers are much more than the average occupation. And thirdly, most importantly, a feature of the STEM and the mad scientist is that you, in fact, are mad, making a difference. You make a difference in feeling that you're helping to improve our world and the STEM ranking from number 28. You can actually make a difference, and you will make a difference. As I like to say, you youngsters are only 25% of the population, but represent 100% of our future. I'm delighted to share this very special moment with you. Thank you and best wishes for your continued success.
Thank you, Dr. Nicholson, for helping these students to become the next generation of scientists and engineers for our country. My name is Carla Duhaney, and I'm the Vice President of Administration here at the South Florida Science Center, and we have an exciting night planned for you all. We have a wonderful team of artists and scientists here tonight. I would like to introduce Guy Harvey and his daughter, Jessica. Guy Harvey is a unique blend of artist, scientist, diver, angler, conservationist, and explorer. Growing up in Jamaica, Guy spent many hours fishing and diving with his father. He was obsessed with the creatures of the sea and began drawing pictures of the many different fish he observed. A marine biologist at heart, he graduated from Aberdeen University in Scotland with a marine biology degree and a doctorate in fisheries biology from the University of West Indies. He's an avid scuba diver and a skilled underwater photographer. His love of art, along with his scientific background, has enabled him to capture the intricate details in his paintings. Guy's artwork can be found in art exhibits, stores, galleries, and restaurants throughout the world. Along with Guy Harvey today is his daughter, Jessica, who currently works as the project manager for the Cayman branch of the Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation. She and her team provide logistical assistance for conducting scientific research on pelagic species and southern stingrays. She has a bachelor's degree in zoology at the University of Edinburgh and spent her early years as a competitive angler. Now Jessica uses this knowledge to work with recreational anglers to actively participate in scientific research. So join me in welcoming Jessica and Guy Harvey to our Mad Scientist Awards ceremony tonight.
Hi there, I'm Guy Harvey, the founder of the Guy Harvey brand. I'm an artist, a marine scientist, and a conservationist.
And I'm Jessica Harvey, project manager for the Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation, an environmental conservationist, and Guy Harvey's daughter. We are grateful for the opportunity to speak with you this evening, all the way from our home in the Cayman Islands. We are passionate about exploring our oceans. We learn something new every time we are out there. Our marine ecosystem can only work properly if there is a large amount of biodiversity, it's healthy and balanced. That is what we strive for at the Guy Harvey Ocean Foundation every day.
And I started my career many moons ago as a child growing up in the countryside of Jamaica with parents who loved the outdoors. My father would take me on the boat and taught me how to fish. My mother later introduced me to Ernest Hemingway's famous book, The Old Man and the Sea. I was so excited about the story while reading the book that I felt compelled to illustrate it. So at the age of 18, I completed 60 pen and ink pieces that are now exhibited at the Customs House Gallery in Key West, and are also featured in my very first book, Santiago's Finest Hour. As my interest in fish grew, it pushed me to study marine science at the University of Aberdeen and to complete a PhD in fisheries science at the University of the West Indies. And though I'm a self-taught artist, I knew the only way I was going to improve and paint with authenticity was to study the subjects I wished to illustrate. So my scientific training has allowed me to harness the power of observation, pay attention to detail, and to have the courage to immerse myself safely in their environment, as well as beginning to explain the dynamics of the balanced ecosystem and the threats it faces on a daily basis. With knowledge comes power, and as we completely rely on our environment for our survival, we have to work hard to make sure that we conserve it.
I've been privileged to be brought along on amazing journeys with my family since I was 5 years old. It is these experiences that have helped me as an environmental conservationist make a difference through one action at a time. And that is why you, as Mad Scientist Award recipients, are so important to that, because we need your help, your ingenuity, and your dedication to help make this world a better place. Along the way, I have learned a few things that I thought might be helpful for you as you pursue a career in a similar field. Here's a quick video on those tips.
Studying and documenting nature is so much fun. You get to travel to amazing places, see things that very few people have had the opportunity to witness, meet amazing people, and make a positive impact on our community. Being able to do good quality research is a life skill that will be invaluable anywhere you go. Nature is unpredictable, but can be resilient if we give it a chance. It also means you have to be extremely patient. Success is when preparation meets opportunity, and sometimes it can take weeks or months to prepare to document a moment in nature. Your patience will be tested, but it's always worth it because you are always learning something new about yourself and or your environment. Learning another language is invaluable. Not only are you able to communicate to a wider audience, but you are also able to sink deeper into a culture and earn more respect when you try. Understand, there is no one-size-fits-all to education. Everyone learns differently, everyone has different interests, and you have to take that into consideration and be willing to learn and adapt to your audience. Science, technology, engineering, and mathematics go hand in hand with art. Without art, we would not be able to design anything, much less visually explain concepts and ideas that are worth learning about. The only way to improve your skills is to practice them and not think about what mistakes you might make along the way. Mistakes and successes are equally amazing learning opportunities. I'm speaking from experience. Get as much field experience as you can, whether it's volunteering with a group or documenting your own adventures. Dad writes in his diary every day, and it has been such a valuable resource for scientific observations and history of events used in a multitude of platforms.
It is our collective responsibility to conserve the marine environment and to maintain the biodiversity of this planet.
With the ocean heating and the acidity of water increasing at the current rate, how long will it be before microorganisms, coral reefs, and ocean life are destroyed?
Microorganisms, coral reefs, and living organisms in those ecosystems are already affected by the temperature change in the ocean and by the acidification. Isn't that correct?
Absolutely. And it is happening faster and faster every day, the more that we are putting dangerous things into our atmosphere. And so we need to do everything in our power to reverse that before it's too late.
How can we, as citizens of the Earth, do better besides recycling?
We, as citizens of the Earth, can do a lot more for this planet besides recycling. Number one is to ask ourselves before buying anything, do we really need it? Two, we can be sure of where our food is coming from, particularly if it's sustainably sourced, so that we are not making an even more negative impact on our resources. We can also make a difference by being conscientious of what energy we're using in our own households. That's really important. Simply turning off the lights when we don't need it, or being conscientious of use of AC, are all little things that add up and help our environment not be stressed by so many different pressures.
So what you're really saying is reduce our emissions of hydrocarbons, because it's that going into the atmosphere that causes the acidification of the ocean. It affects any animal that has a calcareous skeleton. That includes coral reefs and all the inhabitants that are sedentary there as well. Mm-hmm. And so they're all at risk now of losing their hard parts, basically.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Yeah. And the thing too is be willing to learn something new every day, and learn that we can't just stop learning, in the sense of when there's something new that we can adapt our own behaviors for to make it better. That's, we're learning every day. So we have to make the effort to do that. I mean, you have a PhD in fishery science, but that doesn't mean you've stopped learning.
Quite true.
So being willing to do that, being open-minded, and working with a team to actually support environmental change in your own community. That's very, very important. We have a very powerful voice. And as soon as we recognize that, we can make a huge impact and influence the people who are responsible for making policy change towards a sustainable future.
And to lead by example where feasible, like yes. You have an electric car now.
Yes, I do. It's fantastic.
And we have solar panels on our roof, and mm-hmm. we've reduced our consumption of electricity by almost 2/3. Mm-hmm. So, yeah.
What is the most gratifying thing you have done in your line of work?
Apart from catching some really big fish and diving in some fantastic places, all of which is really gratifying, and of course the results are painting some really wonderful paintings, I have to say. I think the most gratifying thing nowadays for us, Jessica, is to have this marine education initiative.
Absolutely. Education is the single most important thing that is going to help people understand the value of our ecosystem. And I am so excited for all the resources that we are now making available thanks to various partnerships in the States. And we are hoping that you as scientists are going to be able to have access to that and put your own spin so that we can create even more amazing resources. But it is really gratifying to see how we can use art as a tool for telling the story of the way our oceans work, the importance of them, and what we can do to help. Just by looking at this amazing piece, it is extremely gratifying to be actually be able to see this in real life. So in pursuing a career in this field, it is so much fun. I really, really enjoy it. And it's been a pleasure being able to do it with this one right here.
Thank you.
How does your science background influence your art?
My art is very positively affected by my scientific knowledge. I mean, I really benefit from my knowledge of the anatomy, the physiology, and the ecology of these species to be able to paint them authentically. I strive for reality, and so while my work is not photographic, it's still accurate and authentic in that respect. And I think most wildlife artists nowadays strive to be accurate and to tell a little bit about the life history of the animal that they're painting. And that's what I think I've done.
Mm-hmm. And what's amazing too is that science and art has always been linked. You've never put yourself in a box or another. And I think that's one of the things that you as scientists now can take full advantage of.
For sure.
Is the fact that there's no one way of doing things. Having some kind of artistic creativity to help with your work is going to help you think outside the box. And so if you are an artist and are unsure of how to marry the two, don't be afraid. Dad's done it. And there are so many people like you who are wanting to do it too.
What has been your experience of a lifetime?
There have been many, but I have to say at the top of these many great experiences, and there have been some bad ones too that are memorable, have been having Alex and yourself out there in the field with me, whether it's fishing or diving or both, mm-hmm. on these expeditions, making documentaries, because you're both pretty good at what you do. And so any experience like that were fantastic. But you know, there are individual ones that stand out, like catching that 600-pound swordfish in Mexico, some of the world records that you both caught in Panama or Costa Rica or places like that. And from a diving perspective, diving with friends and family, probably one of the greatest ones of all has been diving with schools of striped marlin mixed in with sea lions feeding on sardines and whales intermingled with everything else. I mean, some pretty outrageous experiences. Yeah.
That is amazing.
All coming out in my new book called Guy Harvey's Underwater World, which will hit the shelves in May.
Right. Yeah. And so definitely encourage you guys to have a look. But also there's a load of other places that we've been to, like the Galapagos Islands, Cocos Islands, Isla Mujeres, to see the whale shark aggregation.
That's very cool.
Yeah, it's amazing. And so I really encourage every one of you to have a look around the world and see what's happening, because there are so many natural wonders, and it does take a bit of effort, but when you get it all together, the moment is so intoxicating.
And many thanks to all the captains and crews mm-hmm. that have enabled these interactions
yes.
to happen. Being in the right place at the right time with the right crew is pretty important.
Absolutely.
So thanks to all those guys and girls.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Thank you so much for this opportunity, and thank you very much for your questions.
And now for the best part of the evening, the Mad Scientist Awards. These students are some of the best and brightest of the Palm Beach and Martin counties. This has been a particularly difficult year, and many of the students completed their projects at home with limited mentorship, so we are particularly proud of them. Over 400 students participated this year, and students created a video for judging and were judged virtually by volunteers from our STEM community. Congratulations to each and every one of you, and thank you to the sponsors and partners that made this possible.
Valerie Gaynor, Science Coordinator for the Martin County School District. On behalf of our team, thank you for coming to this year's Mad Scientist Awards and celebrating the achievement of these amazing students. This evening would not be possible without our sponsors. We are grateful for the support that they've provided our students and extend a special thank you to the Stiles Nicholson Foundation and the South Florida Science Center and Aquarium. Also, thank you to our keynote speakers, Dr. Guy Harvey and Jessica Harvey, for inspiring our students to fish for new knowledge and dive deep into STEAM. Congratulations to our mad scientists. You are the innovators, risk takers, and you are truly making a difference in our world.